Namaskar, I am Dr. K K Aggarwal, President, Heart Care Foundation of India and Group Editor in Chief MEDtalks. The question I am going to answer about is, who am I? Am I the body? Am I the mind? Am I the soul? Am I K K Aggarwal? Am I a cardiologist? No, K K Aggarwal is my name, it's not me. Cardiologist is my profession. Medicine is my profession. Padma Shri is my award, but that's not me. Then who am I? Am I my physical body? No, my physical body will go. Once my physical body goes, I may still be there. My name may still be there. Am I my mind? No. Am I my soul? Maybe. We need to understand then what is soul. I may be a sum total of my physical body, mind and soul. For this, I need to understand in two sections, the Advait philosophy and Advait philosophy. In Advait philosophy, God is in me, I am the God. In Advait philosophy, God is different, I am different, and I want to become like God. Advait philosophy is for intellectuals. Advait philosophy basically means Aham Brahmasmi, that I am God. If I am God, then I need to understand then who is God. Am I not egoistic by saying I am God? No, it is beyond ego. When I say that I direct all my actions towards my consciousness, then I need to understand what is this consciousness. For this I need to understand that I am made up of five basic elements: space, air, fire, water and earth. These five elements of the nature, when they form my body, they will convert my body into three actions: Vata, Pitta and Kapha, which is movement, metabolism and structure. They in turn will make seven dhatus: Rasa, Rakta, Mamsa, Medha, Asthi, Majja, Shukra. That means they will make plasma, blood, muscle, adipose tissue, bone marrow and the ojas or the essence. Now these seven dhatus in my body will make an element. They will make an atom. If I divide this atom, that now if I go back to the formation of the atom, these atoms will form subatomic particles. Subatomic particles will make proton, electron and neutron. They will be in turn made up of photons. Photons in turn will be made up of quantum. Quantum in turn will be made up of energy. Energy waves, multiple waves. Multiple waves in turn will be connected to a single wave. Single wave in turn will be connected to a single line, that means a silent wave which is not moving, and that silent wave will arise out of an ocean of nothing, and that nothing is called consciousness. So I am nothing but the consciousness. That means my consciousness, which is the silence, the most silent state of awareness, when I am in an extreme parasympathetic state of mind, then I am God. So therefore, if I want to become God, then I need to shift from sympathetic to parasympathetic mode to an extreme degree of parasympathetic state of mind with no sympathetic activity, absolutely non-wind, wavering mind, which may not be easy. And that's the reason in today, we don't have a God-like character no more left, because we don't know. There may be some living in caves, but in our materialistic world, we don't find the Kalki of today. Therefore, that silent state of awareness is the consciousness. In that silent state of awareness, a thought arises in the form of a wave. A thought arises, and that thought, if it is fulfilled, it ultimately leads to action, memory and desire, and it leads to habits. And if it is non-fulfilled, it leads to anger. Anger can be in, anger can be out, or anger can be controlled there like a nilkant. And if anger is out, you go into aggressive behavior. If anger is in, you end up into a despondency, depression, frustration, acidity. And if you neutralize your anger the Shiva way, you may be able to help. Therefore, who am I? I am the sum total, I am the largest pharmaceutical ornamentarium in the world. I am the consciousness, I am the silent state of awareness. I am a state of mind where there is absolutely no wavering and no wandering. And whatever I ask, my consciousness will tell you. And if I take conscious based decisions, then I will be able to live a normal life. So somebody asked me, who are you? So I am an extreme parasympathetic state of mind, which is absolutely focused, absolutely silent state of awareness, which I can arouse to a spirit as a spiritual prescription by using two mantras, and that is attention and intention. So whenever in my state of mind I have in my intention, I enter inside with an attention, and then when I focus my attention over that intention, dharana, dhyana and samadhi, that action is a yogic action, and that action is going to be the right action. Thank you.